David, Richie, since moving across the pond to the States, you know what we haven't eaten a lot of?
I got it. It's gotta be bangers and mash.
Or a nice old delicious shepherd's pie.
Oh, come on, bros. Quit taking a piss. It's fish and chips.
Welcome to another episode of Fun Bros Food.
We're in Alhambra, California right now, and we are about to have some authentic British fish and chips.
With a slight Indian twist.
Let's go.
Fish and chips.
What's going on? What is one really English thing we can tell the audience who may have never had any of this before?
The chips. They're not fries, they're chips. They're thicker than fries. We cook them twice. They're really crispy on the outside, soft and buttery on the inside.
My question is, so what do you call potato chips?
Crisps.
They're not fries, they're chips. We gotta start with the swai, man. I don't mean to excite you too much. Swai is from Vietnam.
Tell me I knew that though, from the Mekong Delta.
Alright, so usually fish and chips is made with a cod or any other fish but swai fish.
Anything but swai, right?
Swai, but swai is coming up in the fish and chips game.
Actually, I heard it's because cod worldwide has been overfished.
Yo, Vietnam, we need to take control of our fish. They're taking our fish.
But they said it's sustainable farming. It's in a farm.
Oh, for sure.
All right. Farm raised swai.
This is the type of fish you call angel meat. The way you just broke that, the meat was so fluffy looking, it looked like angel meat, bro.
For those of you who haven't had fish and chips, of course, it is a British food.
This is pretty much like burgers in America is fish and chips to them. They still eat burgers, but mostly fish and chips.
Lemon.
That is really good.
If you ain't eating swai, I don't know why.
Pretty fly for a swai guy.
Come on.
Okay, so this is the cod. It's a little thicker though, you can tell. It's a more brolic fish.
This is more traditional. If you guys eat regular fish and chips, you might be more used to this. I'm all about the real traditional. I like to keep it with the tartar sauce.
Tarsons, that's the classic British vinegar right there.
Are we in lock, stock, and two smoking barrels right now?
Are we in the Spice Girls?
Tiny Tempa, getting it now. You know, in the game, I figured it out.
Hey, shout out to David Beckham. You know, the swine fish actually has a more firmer feel. I feel like it holds together more. The cod is a little mushy.
Those are the cutest little samosas.
Once you pop, you just can't stop.
Still packs that curry punch.
Zucchini stick. You challenge the kingdom of Mordor. I will lay you to waste with my zucchini.
Oh my God, look at that juice, bro.
Whoa.
Those fried mushrooms are pretty good. Don't take it for granted.
The donor chips. Donor means lamb, a certain type of shaved lamb.
Basically, anything over twice cooked fries is pretty good.
All right, you guys ready?
Richie's bite looks crazy.
God save the queen.
So the reason why there is curry here in the first place is because Sonny is Indian from Britain.
Indian people have been in England for almost as long as America has existed. About 200 years, because Britain colonized India a really long time ago. Anyway, shout out to Gandhi and all that.
Shout out to Jay Sean. And you don't really hear about this too often, like, compared to the French with the Vietnamese.
No.
This is pretty under the radar.
I think Asian British food is not really a commercial in America. There's only a few spots you can get it at, and this is one of them.
What do you guys know about British rap? Stevie Ho Wang.
Oh, man, that is old school. That is old school, man. Yo, what do we got here?
The donut wrap.
Okay, this is like a pita, like a big gordita. This meal, with salad dodging. You're dodging the salad. That means you're eating everything but the healthy stuff.
Oh, okay. You know what? Obviously, right here, you have a proper English sandwich.
Oh, bruh. My gosh. I'm not gonna lie, guys. I should be getting paid for that, ripping things in half.
Nobody does it quite like you do.
All right, you got beans flown in from England, so these are English beans.
Oh, my English beans.
This looks crazy. This looks like something, you know, in home ec class.
Yeah.
When you gotta make your own burger.
It's got a good balance of cheese, bacon, beans, patty, onions.
They grilled that bread with butter.
Yes. Yeah.
This is a French fry, AKA chip sandwich, bro. My opinion on Chip Buddy is that it's pretty interesting to use chips in place of your protein.
I mean, you're eating a bunch of fries stuffed in a sandwich.
Sonny, you are an authentic Indian British person.
I am, yes.
And your family's been in England for many, many years.
Yes.
How British are you?
Do you like Mr. Bean?
Yes.
Do you like Benny Hill?
Yes.
Have you watched the movie The Kingsman?
Yes.
James Bond?
Every Brit loves James Bond.
Doctor Who?
I don't like Doctor Who.
You don't like Doctor Who?
David Beckham?
Yes.
Oh, Sherlock Holmes?
I love Sherlock Holmes.
Spice Girls?
Yes.
Robbie Williams?
Yes.
The Royal Family?
I'm a royalist.
What does that mean?
It means you like the Royal Family?
Oh, you like
Monty Python. Monty Python is a classic.
Tiny Temple?
Yes.
Dizzy Rascal?
Yes.
What do you think of British stereotypes? Because I think America obviously has a really strong British influence a long time ago. There is a sense that like its best years are behind. In America, people think that anything worth in England is like in the past.
That's what sells over here. You know, Downton Abbey is huge. People love watching stuff like that. So it perpetuates the stereotype.
Are you optimistic about the future of Britain?
I'm in America now.
Okay.
I'm an American.
In the same way that fries in America are chips in England, we in England are Oriental, and Indians in America would be Asian in England.
So it just kind of goes to show you that whatever you call Oriental or Asian is just kind of dependent on your country.
And it also kind of depends on who conquered you first.
All right, bruvs, that was a delicious British meal.
My major takeaway is that it's really interesting that a lot of Americans have these misconceptions about England, even though if you look at history, America is a derivative of English culture, obviously mixed with a bunch of other stuff. We're Asians, we understand what it's like to be stereotyped by the media unfairly. And I think it's interesting that America ended up stereotyping the culture that it came from to the point where they think it's old and archaic and outdated, but clearly the fish and chips is hitting and they're very modern.
America's like, Mom, you're not cool anymore.
In Britain, fish and chips is such a big thing. And now I'm starting to wonder what other British dishes could make it to America and kind of, you know, be popular out here.
Yeah, I thought it was cool trying out all these British dishes and not so just British dishes, but British Indian influence as well.
Shout out to Hot Red Bus and their authentic, delicious fish and chips.
Definitely come support the owner, Sonny, his wife, Sage. Very cool people.
Let us know in the comments below if you are British or if you've ever had British food or what other types of food you'd like us to try.
And until next time, we out.
Peace.
Oh, you know I had to go in with the swai because straight from Vietnam, like me. Anyways, make sure you check out this video. Make sure you check out this video. Also leave in the comments below if you guys want us to check out any other places, what other foods you want us to try out. Oh, snaps. And also subscribe to my page.
Yo. Is it safe to call that the Viet swag fish?
Oh! Wow.
We out! You gotta throw a Supreme hat on it, maybe. Alright, we out.
Peace!